Hey, what's up, guys? Glock9 here, and welcome back to Cabin in the Woods. It is the morning of day 22, and before we get a move on, let me just show you what's going on up here. We had a bit of an issue in the last episode during Horde Night with these zombies when they broke through the bars, which I have replaced with wood ones. We just need to upgrade those to iron later, but they were getting stuck right here and beating on this block. They almost broke through it. And that would have been a problem because there's nothing below this block, so they just would have been falling down there, and that would have fucked everything up. Now, these bars right here are part of the problem. We got to get rid of all three sets of bars here. We'll do that later before the horde shows up, but with those gone, at least the zombies will be falling off right here because they were really just piling up in this tight little space, and I think that is what was kind of preventing them from jumping up to where we are. I put these bars in also. They need to be upgraded to iron. We could probably go down another row if we wanted to, and these are just to prevent spider zombies from jumping up to where we are. But anyway, that's pretty much it. We got a little bit of work there to do tonight before the horde shows up. For now, though, we are headed to the south to go see Trader Rick. It's Trader Day. All of their inventories reset. I got a whole bunch of shit I want to sell, and we also need oil shale. We're completely out of that and out of gasoline, so we're gonna go see Rick first. Actually, we're gonna mine some oil shale first, then we'll go see Rick, then we'll go see Trader Jen, we'll pick up a job from her, then we'll go see the snow trader, do that job for Jen, and at that point, it'll probably be time to head home and start getting ready for the horde. Alright, we got a couple of ores right here we can mine. There was a bird chasing us. I guess he decided to fuck off. Let's go ahead and eat this Rockbuster candy and do some mining. What's up, Rick? I'm gonna eat this butt traveler first before we engage in business. See, I remembered this time. Writing it on my hand really paid off. Oh, look at this. I forgot we were due XP and coin from that cheerleader challenge. All right, I got a whole bunch of shit I need to sell you here, and then we'll take a look at your inventory. Alright, he took everything except for this piece of armor right there, which is not a big deal. We'll sell that to either Jen or the Snow Trader. Gonna take all of his gunpowder, the AP 9mm, the bullet casings. What else, Rick? Bullet tips. Should I take these rocket frags? He has 7 of them. I'm gonna skip them for now. I'll be pissed off if we get our hands on a rocket launcher soon. But who knows how long it could be until we get one. And we have some rocket frags back at home. I'd rather spend the money we have on ammo that we can use right away if we need to. Alright, I guess that's it. Let's check his vending machine. Ooh, eye candy. Beautiful. We'll use that after the horde, before we loot the loot bags. Granted, we survived tonight, which I'm sure we will. We've been doing pretty damn good. And I think the setup is going to work well tonight. I'm torn. I kind of want to let the zombies break through again to see if the slight changes I made affect the way they behaved last night. But I don't want to do that right away. So I think I'm going to repair the bars to buy us some time, but I'll probably let them break through towards the end of the horde. This way, if it doesn't work out the way I think it will, it's not a very big horde that we have to deal with. You know what I mean? So anyway, let's get over to Trader Jen. We'll see if we can sell her this one piece of armor that Rick didn't want. And we'll see what she has in her inventory. Grab a job from her. Go see the Snow Trader. Do that job for Jen. And we'll be looking good. Oops, are you okay, buddy? Oh, no, you're not. That's a shame. I guess I'll just harvest the body for the meat, then. Not much going on in here. I will take the Rockbuster candy, though. And you know what? I'll take the chili as well. We're getting a little hungry. We've been working hard this morning. We deserve it. What's up, Jen? Let me see. You want to buy this armor?
I get lonely sitting by myself all day.
All right, let's see what you got now. All right, I guess let's do this fetch clear quest. That's to the west, which is back towards our cabin. So it shouldn't be too bad. That's a little bit past our cabin. And it is kind of far from the snow trader, but whatever. We'll make it work. Ooh, more eye candy. I'll take that. And I think that's it. Yeah, we're good. I'm going to go ahead and eat our chili now, though. Get nice and full. And let's see what Hugh Jackman got for sale. Oh, a good amount of gunpowder. I'll take all that. Take the 7.62. And the AP-7.62. And the AP-9mm. And the regular 9mm. Check his secret stash. Here we go. Hold on. I want to see what this pistol Pete is. Nah. Let's just take the shotgun shells and the AP-7.62.
If there's nothing else,
and that's it. That's pretty good. We got a shit ton of ammo today, and we got coin left over. Let's head towards this job though for Jen. Get that done. Fuck off. Waiting for me at the door like I'm your date and shit. What the fuck? Let's do this job. Go get our reward from Jen. And we'll head home and get ready for the horde. Oh, we already looted this place. The U.S. fire post, but that's all right. We'll do it again. There's some decent loot here. And we'll also get a reward out of the deal from Jen. Food and armor. Come on down, buddy. Oh, look how nimble you are landing on your feet. Now I'm gonna bash your head in. All right, here we go. Now I know there are dogs in those kennels over there. I mean, last time I was here, I figured there were dogs in those kennels and they still bolted out and ran at me and chased me into this building right here. We're gonna try and play it a little bit smarter this time. Some trash back here. All right, let's clear and loot this building first before we do anything else. You know what? Let's just get on top of the kennel. Oh shit, come on. There we go. And we'll just shoot down on these fuckers. There you go. You gotta be smarter than the dogs. We got a purse in here. Nothing. Nothing else going on here. We could dig up the cement, and it sounds like we woke up the zombies in this building right here. Or that might be coming from outside the wall. All right, let's help Mo out so he's not out there. Oh, shit. Oh, I hit her with the ratchet. She must have been hiding behind the desk. All right, now let's help Mo out. I think that's it for in here. Let's go ahead and scrap this bandana, the sweatshirt, chairs, and nails. And let's move on to this building. It's the mess hall in here. Let's clear the bathroom. We're good. Nothing in the toilet. Alright, I'm sure there are zombies in that other room. Let's see if we can search the kitchen quietly as I bash open this cabinet with my flaming steel club. Nice. Sounds like we woke someone else up, though. Oh, big boy was up on the rooftop. Back up, dude. Oh, I was supposed to use that cement to climb up on the rooftop. I guess I gotta make a wood frame real quick. And we'll use that instead. I don't think there are any birds up here. Don't see any. Let's bring our spear back down. And let's proceed this way. This is where the main loot is, so I'm kind of doing this POI a little backwards, but that's fine. Because we'll have one more building to raid after we grab the main loot here. Come on. Wake up. I know there are zombies up there. I'll see these motherfuckers. All right. Try harder next time, guys. You know, something I didn't do in this episode that I said I was going to in previous episodes was bump up the XP multiplier. I haven't changed anything, but you know what? I definitely think I am going to do that in the next episode and moving forward in this series just to crank things up a little bit. All it's going to do is provide me with a little bit more XP as I do shit. It'll make us level up faster. It'll make our game stage go up faster. And it'll make the zombies a bit harder, which we could use, all right? I mean, the zombies are pretty easy. We're doing really well. And I think it'll give the series a good boost forward. All right, I think the courier satchel is right down here. Oops. Ow. Fucking barbed wire. There we go. Now all we gotta do is finish killing the zombies. There's at least one more in here. There we go. Two more. Dead. And dead. Alright. I think there's a little bit of loot up here. Just maybe like some medical supplies. And then we're done. Just past hour 15, that's good. Gives us plenty of time to get home. And actually, we gotta go see Jen first. Get our reward, hopefully it's ammo. And then we'll get home and start preparing.
Well, aren't you a sniper?
Level 2 pistol, aw, that's some bullshit.
What can I get you?
You know what it is? I think I'm just so used to the great rewards we were getting in the maxed out series because we had whatever perk that is that gets you better rewards for the trader obviously was maxed out. And we were getting just all sorts of crazy shit. Not only were we getting great rewards, but we got to choose two of them because that perk was maxed out. Maybe we should be working towards leveling up that perk. I keep saying that perk. I don't remember off the top of my head which one it is, but maybe it's Daring Adventurer, but we should work towards maybe leveling that perk up before we start doing a bunch of jobs for the trader. That might make more sense. But anyway, let's get home and get ready for a fight. Alright, here we go. Now, I have additional iron bars on me. I was gonna put an additional set here in front of the doorway because I can put one in between the hatch and the iron bars that are currently there, but I just thought two sets of iron bars might be overkill at the front. Plus, they really break through the bars fast here, so it's almost like a waste. And on top of that, I didn't want to screw anything up. Maybe they might see the cement wall as a faster way to get in than the iron bars. Probably not. They'd still go for the iron bars because, in reality, it is less hit points to break through two iron bars than two blocks of reinforced concrete. But, like I said, I didn't want to fuck anything up, so we'll just hold on to these iron bars. Holy shit, we gotta go, man. Wow, that happened fast. Holy fuck, that might... Oh! Stupid spider zombie. Yeah, I should have went down another row on those iron bars for sure. But too late now. Let's just work on beating the shit out of them as quick as we can. I am going to repair these iron bars in the beginning here just to keep them at bay when the horde is crazy. But towards the end, as I feel it's thinning out, I'm probably going to let them break through just so we can make sure that the step here by the hatches is going to work. I mean, all I did really was remove the iron bars there, but because I did that, that should prevent a major bottleneck here at the steps. The zombies should be falling off now. And because there's no major bottleneck, that should hopefully get them to jump up on the step where the hatch is. But who knows? We'll find out in a little bit, I guess. It's going pretty good. I mean, we get a few cops in the beginning, but we haven't really been getting cops mid to late horde. And certainly we haven't gotten any radiateds yet, and of course no demolishers yet. This is kind of what I'm hoping will happen once I bump up the XP multiplier in the next episode. It might not happen immediately, but maybe two or three episodes after bumping up the XP multiplier, we'll probably see a major change in the Horde Knights, which I'm looking forward to. Because it is getting a bit repetitive, even though my plan for a larger Horde is exactly the same as what we're doing now. Hold off at these bars as long as I can, repairing them, and then fall back to the hatches. It should just be a lot more exciting when there's a lot more cops, there's radiated zombies, and there's demolishers involved. Because as it stands, this is pretty fucking easy. I mean, they haven't even broken through the first set of bars yet. I'm done repairing them for now, so they probably will break through those soon. And whether or not they break through the second set, who knows? Because I'm not letting up. I'm just going to keep kicking the shit out of them. You know, I can definitely prevent them from even breaking through the first set if I want to, because I still have more forged iron. But I'm not going to do that. We'll see if they can make it through, and then if they can, we'll fall back to the hatches and see if removing those bars makes a difference. Alright, fuck it. Let's get some more fire down there, and then we'll back up behind these hatches. Oh, shit. We're on fire. And I've got no water. Does honey put out fire? No, it doesn't. Shit. I gotta remember to bring water. I haven't set myself on fire in so long. I've been taking it for granted. We'll use a painkiller. Get our hit points back up, and let's pop these hatches open. And any day now, guys, you can go ahead and break through those bars. Come on, you fucks, break through them already. There we go. Okay, now jump up here. Come on, jump. There we go. Yes. Oh, Mo just died. Probably from the fire. And Junkie's shooting the shit out of him. So much for this test. Here we go. Come on. Jump on up. There we go. See? When there's nothing blocking them, and there's not a whole bunch of zombies crammed in that little area, they jump right up. Look at that. Beautiful. I think it was just they were getting too bottlenecked in the area. It could also have been the dead bodies piling up. But the dead bodies don't seem to affect them at all. Look, I mean, there's plenty of dead bodies there, and they're still jumping up. I really think it was the bottleneck that was preventing them from jumping up here. So, that's good. That's great, actually. All right, come on up here, bitch. Good night. And good night. And that's it. We're done. Man, that was a pretty successful horde night, if I don't say so myself. That block hardly took any damage at all. Son of a bitch. Fucking cornmeal. But yeah, removing those bars was a great idea. That really, get the fuck out of here, cornmeal. That really, helped the issue we were having in the last episode. Let me search this loot bag, and let's get a hatch put down here. So that's good. We'll get the rest of these loot bags picked up. I'll get this loot organized, and that'll be it. Oh, shit. Forgot to eat this eye candy. Good thing I remembered now and not when we were done looting all of these bags. We only grabbed a few of them. That's all right. We'll get the majority of them now. With the candy in our system. Hoping to find a rad remover here. Still haven't found one of those, but no radiated zombies have shown up either, so it's not a big deal at this point anyway. See if we can find one in the next episode, or like I was been saying, the schematic, so we can craft one. You know, we did find the schematic to the auger a few episodes back, and I haven't even looked to see if we can craft one of those yet, so maybe I'll take a look tonight and see if we can get one made so we can start opening up the bunker a bit more. There's another loot bag up here. All right, we got a book here. Shotgun Messiah. Shotguns do 10% more damage. Fucking beautiful. All right, guys. That's going to be it for this episode. I'm going to get all of this loot organized, and we'll pick things up here on the morning of day 23. Guys, I hope you enjoyed this episode, and I hope you're looking forward to seeing more. Thank you so much for watching and all the support. It really does mean a lot. You guys can follow me on Instagram or Twitter. It's at Glock9Gamer. I follow all gamers back. Stick around for more Cabin in the Woods, and I will catch you guys in the next episode.